Hello? Hello? Hmm, no one's there.
Magnus? Magnus, is that you?
Guess again.
Uh-oh.
Who is this?
Wait, I can explain. I didn't know he was going to go missing, and okay, so I haven't filled out all the daily logs for the guy in months, and yes, okay, so I napped through all of the training videos, but I didn't mean to, and I guess what I'm saying is please don't fire me.
I'm not here to fire you.
So you're not working with my boss?
Nope.
Oh man, that's a relief. Well then, this is control tower number 32, operator Alex Lintrong speaking.
Hi Alex, I'm Nancy. I'm a detective trying to find out more about Magnus.
Magnus? He's gone, isn't he? I wanted to say something, but I didn't want to get in trouble.
What did you hear?
Some pretty messed up stuff. I don't know if I can tell you.
Why not?
Whoever took him, they might come after me too. And if my boss finds out someone went missing on my watch and I didn't report it... Look, I need this internship. If I get fired here, I'll be a barista until I die. I'm allergic to coffee, man. I can't go back. I can't go back to that life.
Alex, slow down and stay calm. I need your help. If what you're saying is true, Magnus might be in serious danger. But you don't have to handle this alone.
Okay, I heard Magnus calling in early morning, same as always, just to say hi, around 6. Then we started chatting, just like we always do. He was excited about the ship he was piloting. He said it was his baby. He started pulling into Skiprot Harbor. I heard a voice on board, I mean. He went to go check it out, left the radio on. I heard shouting, fighting, then nothing. Just silence.
That's not good. I think this investigation just went from missing persons to abduction.
It's dark out there, and the water's cold. But I know he didn't go on his own. That's why I'm keeping my head down.
Could you hear anything Magnus said?
Something about the ship. That's all I got. I was too scared. Oh, I hope he's okay.
What can you tell me about Magnus?
He's totally weird. Good weird. Not serial killer weird. He's one of those people who rarely speaks, but when they do, it's the most interesting thing you've heard in days. He bottles up thoughts and distills them.
Oh, interesting. Who are you?
Just a lowly undergrad assigned to a cubicle, a pair of headphones, and a computer. I'm here on an internship for my maritime psychology degree. My parents said I'd never find a paying job. Shows them. Me and Magnus, we were kind of buddies. I mean, we never met or anything, but whenever he'd radio in, he always wanted to chat. Not a lot of people want to chat with the intern.
Are you from around here?
Nope. Massachusetts.
So, what are you doing here?
Whoa. Deep. I gotta think about that one. I mean, what are any of us doing in this crazy messed up world, you know?
No, I mean in Iceland, in a control tower, you know, that stuff.
Oh, that! I work in the harbor controller's office. I keep track of ship movement and speak with anyone taking a ship to harbor in Iceland.
What on earth is a maritime psychology degree?
I have a 30-page thesis answering exactly that question, but it can all be boiled down to two words. Sailor feelings.
Oh, interesting. What did you mean by daily logs earlier?
There are these logs I'm supposed to fill out whenever a vessel passes through us.
So, are they filled out?
Kind of. I turned one sheet into an homage to my relationship with my mom, another into this super cool drawing of a whale. I haven't been keeping tabs on vessels as well as I should be.
How cool are we talking?
The coolest! I actually stapled it to my cubicle wall, and regardless, I don't have any records of Magnus going through our waters.
I need a way to distract someone on board this ship.
So you can do what, exactly?
Snoop through their stuff?
Hey, at least you're honest about it. Acceptance is the first step to healing. Yeah, I can help.
What do I do?
Hold up, Klepto. I've got a favor to ask first.
Okay, name your price.
There's a lighthouse near Skiprock. You can probably see it from town. But the light's busted right now. If you can get up there and fix that light, it means I can stay here at HQ with my cup of tea and giant snuggle blanket.
I'll give it a whirl.
My cell number is 978-555-0139. Give me a call when you're standing in front of the light. I'll tell you what to do next.
Have you met Dagny?
Is that the super mercenary one? Always freezing, kinda sassy?
Sounds like her.
She used to call me all the time. Always tried to get information about Magnus's plans to come in and out of harbor. Joke's on her. I'm so disorganized, I can't match my sock colors, let alone keep records of Magnus's charting. She always wanted to know when he'd be gone. I never told her, obviously.
What was she trying to do in his absence?
No clue. But I did some internet stalking on her. One of my many talents. I found out she's wanted in the States for skimming some cash off a treasure find in the Gulf of Mexico.
Oh, that explains why she's been hanging around in Iceland, I guess. Can you tell me about Elizabeth?
Ah, the infamous Seta.
Seta?
It means cutie.
Oh, a pet name.
I know, total barf, right? The hours I spent listening to that guy alternatively complain about her and pine for her. I could write novels. Talk about star-crossed lovers.
They've broken up now.
Yeah, that's the last thing he told me before he went missing. You know, the longer I talk, the more suspicious that sounds.
What do you know about Soren?
That guy who runs the festival?
Yes.
He's worked with us a few times. Always seems like there's something just under the surface with that one. Cheerful and yet angry. Or bitter. Like he was holding something back. They say Icelanders never forget a grudge.
They do.
And by they, I actually just mean me.
Any other information for me?
Not really. Mostly I just kick it in this cubicle and keep my tall ship's lifestyle blog updated. It's called Ship Facts. Want to hear about it?
No thanks. I'm all right. Bye-bye.
Talk to you later.
The motor's intact, but I'll need to replace the spark plugs and cables. It's working. Don't know whose boat this is, but I'll just borrow it for a little while. It's too high to reach at low tide. I should try to get some sleep while I'm here. Well, I made it to the top. Better give Alex a call. Okay, I'm in the lighthouse.
Awesome. I can remote the power from here, but I'm going to need you to get all the pieces in place first. One of our staff programmers wrote a new idiot-proof failure mechanic for it. Anyways, I think you need to mix the color channels to create white light. When all of the channels are white, the light will power back on.
This process sounds anything but simple.
Yeah, exactly. That's programmers for you. Give it a whirl and give me a call if you get stuck.
I need to create white light to get the lighthouse running again. Phew, fixed it. Time to phone Alex again.
Woohoo! Thanks, you saved my butt.
Glad I could help.
Okay, let's talk about stealing stuff.
I prefer the term snooping.
Whatever, Klepto. You need a distraction? I got one. There's an alarm hidden in Magnus's captain's chair.
Back in the wheelhouse?
Yep. Hopefully you're using it for the forces of good, but hey, no judgment.
Uh-oh, that's not good. The windows are open. Oh, it's so cold. I need to get out of here. Okay, small numbers at the bottom, big number at the top. It looks like the pieces add to the total of the piece above them. Oh, that was too close. And somehow, I have a feeling it wasn't an accident.
Blasith.
Can you tell me about the festival sound system?
It's been broken for a week.
Soren told me he was manning the sound system on the morning the Hirlikhide crashed.
What? But that's not possible. There was no sound that day.
Sounds like we've got an alibi that doesn't quite match up. You spend a lot of time here. Don't you have somewhere else to be?
No, I'm still on festival duty. In case of a ship emergency, I'm responsible. This vessel is an antique. Things break suddenly, and it's hard to hear the alarm from the harbor.
I see. Interesting. Did Gunnar do anything unusual leading up to the festival?
Well, if you include the two festivals before this one, certainly. He ruined them single-handedly. Aside from that, only the usual threats. Gunnar swore he'd tie Magnus up and send him out to sea. Gunnar hates Magnus.
Bye-bye.
Bless.